Hello students, today we will see the execution of JDBC program. As we can see here, today we are going to see the sample JDBC execution of the program 15th, that is write a Java program that connects to database using JDBC and it does add and delete, modify and retrieve the operations, that is your query operations that you do in your Oracle, that is in your database management system. So before going with this program, let us understand what is JDBC. Okay, what is JDBC? So JDBC is nothing but its long form is Java Database Connectivity. It acts as an intermediate between the Java and database. Whatever data that you store in the database, it is being connected with your Java program with the JDBC. So we can say that it is an application program interface. JDBC is nothing but an application program interface that interconnects the Java with that of the database. So before understanding in detail the JDBC, okay, before going in detail with the JDBC, let us understand the advantages of JDBC. JDBC is an API that is built upon Java. So it is by default, it enables all the advantages of Java. We already know about the advantages of Java and disadvantages of Java that we studied in the previous classes. Okay. Second one, JDBC is DB independent. Whatever database vendors that creates databases, like example MySQL, Oracle, okay, and DB2, even though with any of the DB vendors, whatever the softwares, your JDBC is very much compatible. Okay. Then third one, using JDBC we can interact with multiple database. As I told, JDBC is DB independent, same thing. Fourth one, we can achieve high performance by using JDBC with the help of prepared statements and callable statements. So right now don't worry about the points fourth and fifth. So we will be going to discuss about these two points in a special video session, wherein we will understand first what are prepared statements and callable statements, and also about the stored procedures. Once we understand these three statements, that is prepared statements, callable statements and stored procedures, we will go further with these advantages of JDBC. Okay, fine. Now we have to create a program, that is write a Java program that connects to database using JDBC and does add, delete, modify and retrieve operations. So first we have to create the program. So the program sample is already been made ready and is being provided to you in the form of a lab manual that is kept in the LMS. So you can watch here, that is the 15th program. Okay, so only one thing that we have to do is just copy and paste it in a suitable area. Now before executing the program, we have to understand what is actually a JDBC is. Okay, so for that, as I told before, JDBC acts as an interface between the, that is intermediate between the Java and the database connector. It acts as a connection provider between the Java program and the database. So for connecting the Java program with that of the database, there are 5 steps. First one is load the driver. Okay, as it is being highlighted, first point is load the driver. Second point is get the DB connection via driver. Don't worry about right now, we are going to discuss about this each and every point in detail as further the program continues. Third point, that is issue SQL queries via connection. Issue SQL queries via connection. Fourth point is process the results that is returned by the SQL queries. And lastly, the fifth point is close all the JDBC objects, right? These 5 points are very important to have the connection between the Java and the database. Please remember. Fine. So now the definition of our program, the definition of our program is to connect to the database, and there some operations are being mentioned, wherein we are going to add within the data, delete whatever added data, modify the data and retrieve the data or display. Okay, so before connecting the Java with that of the database, first we have some data in the database. Before creating the data in the database, we should know how to install the database. So here we have more vendors that provide different types of databases. As I told previously, MySQL is one of the software or a vendor. Oracle is one of the vendor who is going to provide a database. DB2 and more than XYZ. Okay, so in the recent industries we are going with the MySQL. So we are going to learn about how to install the MySQL. Don't worry about it, already in the LMS it is been kept how to install the installation procedure of the MySQL. So here in the LMS, there I have kept a Java JDBC program execution inside which you are going to get all the process, the present video that is going to be explained. And in Java software you are going to get the installation procedures and various software that are used for JDBC. Okay, so this is the installation procedure. After total installation, at some point in the middle of the installation, it will ask for the port number. Please don't change the port number, as it is very important for the reference purpose in the further upcoming Java execution. Please don't change the port number, let it be the same as 3306. Okay, and then at the next part you have to provide the MySQL root password. Okay, so it is better you keep the password as root, so it is very easy to remember. Don't at all change the password. Okay, so in that, further before going to the next, you have to put add user. Therein you have to write the username j2ee, as we are going for the execution of advanced Java programming. Then you have to keep the password as the same as what you have provided here, that is root. Okay, and press OK and go for the next. After installation, it will ask you whether to go for the workbench or not. So please go for the workbench. There in the workbench, first you create a new connection. When you try to create a new connection, it will prompt for the connection name. So either whichever name you can give it. So here I have given the name my local connection, and I am providing the username as j2ee, whatever I given user added there in the installation process. And I'm, after giving this, I'm going to store it in a vault. So in the vault, when it is pressed, it will ask for the password for authentication. So whatever password that we have provided previously, that is a root root, you have to press it here and press OK. So once it has been done, it will show connected to MySQL. Okay, connected to MySQL, and then press OK. So your MyLocal connection is created. Fine. So once it has been created, double click it, you will get the console wherein you can directly write the or create the table and enter the queries. Okay, or you can go for MySQL command prompt. Okay, the command prompt is located in the start menu. Okay, the command prompt is located in start menu. Here MySQL folder will be there. Double click it, here go for a MySQL server, and here you can find the command line client. Okay, so once you click it, the menu will be open. So when it open, it will ask for the password. So the password is root that we have provided during the installation, and press enter. So it will open the console. So now our program requirement is to connect to the database wherein already some data is stored, and we are going to access the data. If we want, we can insert a new data. We can delete the inserted data. Okay, and we can modify the data, whatever that has been inserted, with some reference key, and we can delete or display the data. Okay, so before we have to check whether what type of databases are available. Okay, so first, to check the database, you have to write the command First, you have to write a command show database, SHOW. Show databases with semicolon and press enter. It will display all the database that is been stored. As when I was storing an output, I created a database called Puneet_DB. This database wherein I kept the record to display the output there in the LMS. So now in front of you, I am going to create a new database. Okay, I am going to create a new database and wherein I am going to store the data. To create a new database, the command is create database and the database name. Right now we are executing the JDBC program, so let us give the database name as JDBC lab and press semicolon and press enter. Now it is showing the result as query okay, one row affected. It means that your database is created. Now to look over what databases are presented, so right, go for the previous command, that is show database. Now you can observe the database, that is JDBC lab. So now your database is created. Now once it is created, you have to start using the database. So we have to go inside the database. The command for going inside and or using the space provided by the database, you can use the command as use JDBC lab, press semicolon and enter. So it is stating the output as database changed. So now you are entered the your own created database, that is JDBC lab. Now here you can create a table, you can enter the data. Okay, right now our requirement is very simple. We have to create one table wherein I have to insert some data, like for example hall ticket number. It may be in the case of students, in the case of employees, it may be the number of the employee. Okay, it may be the number of the employee. Let us go for the student. So since in the program, as you can see, I have created a table called as STU, wherein three attributes I am going to add. That is HT number, that is the hall ticket number of a student. STU means student data. Okay, HT number means hall ticket number. S name means student name. Mobile means the mobile number of a particular student. Okay. So now, since I have included already in the program, so I have to create the same table in your database. Okay. So let us go back to the console. You know already how to create a table. So the command is create table. Since the name of the table is STU. Okay. With a small bracket opening. First column is HT number, providing it as not null, because something must be there which is not a null value. Some value must be there. Okay, then first name or as in the program we can see, yes name, that is student name, then it is student mobile. Okay, mobile. So after this I am going to give a primary key. And this primary key I am going to keep it as hall ticket number. This is HT number. Previously there was an error in the code, so it has been created here. So after pressing creating the table, it will show query OK, 0 rows affected. That is, the output is we have created a table. So now if you provide show tables, you can see STU table is created in our database. Okay, that is JDBC lab. Now we have to check what is there in the STU. To check what is there in the STU, we will put the command select star from STU. It is showing empty set because we have inserted nothing there in the table. So now we have to insert some data. Now we are inserting the data directly from the database, that is within the database. Now at least one data we are inserting from directly the database. Next, the data will be inserted directly from your program. Okay. To insert the data in the database, command is insert into STU values, opening of the small bracket, now HT number, it is of type integer, so you provide 502 or else you can provide 501. Since second attribute is a name, so you have to provide a name. Let us give the name as Praveen. And third attribute is regarding the mobile number. Okay. Let us give the mobile number. Then lastly we will close the bracket, press colon, enter. So it is showing one row affected. It is means our data is successfully added in the table. Now go back for the previous command, that is select star from STU. Now you can see the data has been added. In the place of STU number it is 501, and the name Praveen, and the particular mobile number. Now this is what it is present in your database. Now you have to actually not use the database directly. You have to go for your Java program. With the Java program, you have to add the data in the database. To add the data in your database, your JDBC act as a mediator that will take the values from the Java programming. It will take the data from the Java programming and insert into the database. And later on, it will be inserted in the database. Okay. So let us check it. So before going to the actual program, let us see some sample program wherein it is telling it is my first JDBC program, wherein I am going to create the JDBC program that is connecting to a database and it is going to access the data or we can put the data inside and we can see the results and all. So here, as I said, five necessary steps that is to be followed. Those are: load the driver, second one, get the DB connection via driver, third one, issue SQL queries via connection, fourth one, process the results returned by SQL queries, and lastly, close all the JDBC updates. The first step, load the driver. Here, the driver is nothing but a type of a mediator, as that, like, you are using, going to use the SIM, okay? You are going to use the SIM in your mobile. Without the SIM, we cannot get any signal. So SIM is nothing but like a driver, fine? Here, driver acts like a SIM, wherein the driver provides the communication, actual communication that is needed to have the connection, fine? So we have to load the driver. To loading the driver, there are two ways. One is by calling up the the driver class from com.mysql.jdbc.driver, where it is stored in your in library, okay? Then you have to write the next line, where is driver manager, which is going to register for the particular reference variable that is going to be created by you for calling up the, or creating the object for the driver, okay? Next, get the DB connection via driver. To get the DB connection via driver, we should know the path or else URL wherein our MySQL is stored. There is a particular path to be followed or to be written while to have a communication between the database. The particular URL is as follows. It is between the double quotes. First one we have to write as JDBC, then colon MySQL. The vendor that you are using is MySQL. If you are going to use Oracle, you have to mention it Oracle. Okay. For different vendors, different path is there. So now, after this, again colon, then forward two slashes. Then you have to write localhost. Since you are using your localhost, this is your localhost. So you have to write localhost, then colon 3306. As I said, 3306 is the port number where installation as instructed, don't change the port number, otherwise it will be affected. If you forget, then we cannot have a clear cut path and we cannot communicate with the database. So never change the port number. After that, one single forward slash, then you have to write, mention the database name. The database name, just now what we created is, okay, the database that were just created is JDBC lab. Now, since previously I was using Punit_DB, so I have entered the database name as Punit_DB. Now we have to change it to JDBC lab. Then after that, question mark, the username that I am going to, the account where it is stored, that is username J2EE, that we have created the connection in the console, okay? Then password that we have given is J2EE, okay? Then next, for getting the connection, we are going to create an object, okay, of the type connection, wherein here it is connection con is equal to driver manager to get connection, that is with the help of DB URL. Okay, fine. Next, issue SQL queries via connection. Here in the third step, we are going to write the queries. Either we have to fetch the data or insert the data, whatever the process we are going to do. Okay, right now here we are going to fetch the data, that is select start from students information. So the whatever the data that is we are fetching, it is being stored in the query. Okay, then through the connection we are going to create that statement. That statement is being executed via the query. In the query, the data is being fetched. That query is being executed, okay, using the statements. Next, don't worry right now what is this STMT, what is this con and all. Okay, see here, it is a statement object being created, which is being stored in the library called as statement. Okay, we will come to know further as we execute more JDBC programs. Next, process the results returned by SQL queries. When we put the query, that is select star from students information, that is nothing but we are going to get the data from the database. So the data that is being fetched from the database, that is to be stored in the that is should to be displayed. Okay, so now since it is a different program, herein I am going to fetch the detail of the students. The table that was created is, it is consisting of a register number, first name, middle name and last name. So we are going to display all the register number, first name, middle name and last name. It has been displayed. And then lastly, when it is done, we are going to close all the JDBC objects. Why we need to close the objects? Because whenever we are working with any of the stuff or material in the Java, we know that it is all been worked with that of the object. So if it has been opened for a long time or for a continuous time, it will be misutilization of the space that is being provided by the primary memory. To save the memory or to save the particular memory space for a while, you can understand it, to save the memory space, we are going to close the objects so that further different projects can use the memory space, right? So this was the sample program. Let us now go to our main program, wherein we are going to execute the program. The program is write a JDBC program, write a Java program that connects the database using JDBC, enters add, delete, modify and enter the operations. Now already we created a data in the database which is having some value, okay? So we can retrieve, that is we can display the operation. Now the operation that we have to apply is, that is add, that is deleted and modify. So I have written the program wherein it is performing the same thing. Now here you may be having the confusion regarding load of the driver. The loading of a driver can be in the form of two ways, either in this way by creating the object of the driver or by placing the class dot for name. Here in this we are going to place the fully qualified class name. The fully qualified class name is nothing but the total name with that of your package. The package that is stored, the driver class created is stored in the com.mysql.jdbc.driver, like how you have created the package as com.punit.javalab. So in the same manner, com.mysql.jdbc.driver, your package will be present. So I am going to directly call the package. So there is no need to import the particular package. But here, since we have not used that, we are going to import the data. See here, com.mysql.jdbc.driver. Okay. So now, next is, I am going to have the connection with that of the JDBC. That is the second step. What is the second step? Get DB connection via driver. For that, we are going to use the URL. So just now, my URL is changed, right? It is JDBC MySQL localhost 3306. Previously, it was Punit_DB. Now I am going to change the database name. So the database name is JDBC Lab. You can see here JDBC Lab. Fine. So the username and password is as usual that I used before for install at the time of installation. Next, some statements that I am going to print in my console. Okay. Some statements. Okay, so I am going to welcome a student, that is from the Sridatta Institute of Engineering Science. So I am printing the statement, welcome to Sridatta Institute of Engineering and Science. So this in this I am going to get the menu, so wherein I am going to insert data, edit the data, delete the data, display the data, exit. So now for insertion I am going to write the queries. You can see here, enter the option as it of a switch statement that we will use. So we are going to use a switch. So here enter, if it is case 1, insert. So for case 1, insert, it should print enter HT number, or if it is the case HT number, okay. If it is the case name, it will enter a name. If it is the case of mobile. So the SQL query is insert into STU values that we have already seen. So here I am going to write the statement wherein I am going to get the HT number, name and mobile number. next. If I'm going to switch for the edit, fine. So it is case 2. So herein I'm going to update the values. If I'm going to edit, I'm going to update the values. So here I'm going to give the primary number, primary key as ST number. So here I'm going to update the name. So update the STU set name. So update a name with the mobile number, hall ticket number. Okay. So if it is success, it is record updated. If it is a operation is failed, it will display the operation failed. Then third one, delete. Third case, enter ST number that is to be deleted. Delete from the query is delete from the STU where ST number is, the particular ST number you are going to provide it. If it is successful, it will show record deleted. If it is unsuccessful, it will show operation failed. Okay. So next, lastly, fourth one is display. Select star from STU, normal SQL query. Fine. So after this, it is done. After this, it is done. We are going to exit. So fifth one, as in the normal switch statement, we are going to exit. Fine. I'm going to open it. Thank you. Fine. After that, it will close. Next. So after processing the particular output that is to be displayed, that is the first step. Fifth step is got to close. So already we are closing the required connections, that is objects that we are already created, that is CN connection ST statement, which has been created here. As you can see, CN is a reference variable used for the connection, and then EST is the reference variable used for the statement. Result set is not required to be closed. It is not an JDBC object, so we no worry about it. So already we have closed it. And lastly, we are going to end up the execution. Now, once it is done, save the program and then execute it. See here, in the console, you can see welcome to Sri Datta Institute of Engineering and Science. Okay. So now, enter your option. I'm going to insert the data. Enter 1. Okay. It is asking for a hall ticket number. Now already 501 is there. I will enter 502. Enter. It is asking for a name. I will enter PUNIT. Next, enter. Asking for a mobile number. I will enter some mobile number. My mobile number is 9632009954. I'm going to press enter. Record is inserted, as you can see. Now, if I want to display the record, press the option 4. Press enter. It is showing already Praveen information is installed by inserted by your console. Okay. Now let us check in the console whether the inserted data from the Java, that is my new record, that is Puneet with the hot ticket number 502, that is with the mobile number, they're inserted or not. Okay. So simple thing that is to see the records are select star from STU. Now you can see the record is inserted. This means that from Java program, I am going to put to the database. I am going to insert the data in the database through JDBC. So it means that our program is executed. We are going to insert the data through Java program. Now the second option is to edit. I don't think so. We have to go further and waste our time. I think you have understood. Okay. So now it is what the execution of the program. Now you have to understand how to create this actual program, how to have the connection. Okay. So now I will go for the basic step. In the file, new, go for a Java project. Write the project name. Now right now we are going to execute a Java JDBC program. JDBC lab. Lab program. Okay. Press finish. JDBC lab program. It has been created. Okay. When you double click, there is an SRC. Okay. So now, before running the JDBC program, we have to import some jar files. As we in the class of the package, we already discussed about importing and exporting jar files. Jar files are nothing but the zip files, added up the zip files, which are having the supporting library files. So for JDBC, there is a zip file that we have to build. So we have to go for a build path, add external archives. Okay, therein you have to go for the jar file. You can see here dot jar, which is having all SQL related connections or library files. So press open. It has been added in your libraries. Okay, now next, in the SRC you have to go for new package com dot JDBC, or you can write the Punit or your name and JDBC lab program. Okay, then press finish. So a package is created. Now you have to create a class. New, create a class. Okay, let us give the class name as CURD, that has already been used in your program. Okay, press finish. Class is created. The only thing is just copy paste from the class till the end. Okay, it's placed here. Now some errors are there. Okay, so it is done. Now go for a save option. Executed. Okay, you can see here in the console a fresh execution has started. This is what your JDBC program is.